All right, extra stream. Let's see here. If I do my own glob matching, well, I guess I could actually use FN match, right? File name match. Not that it's hard to do, but these POSIX as well. For now, I'm not going to worry about POSIX, and then I'll just refactor later if I have to once I move it over, just because I don't want to have to test on POSIX right now, so it's easier for me to just focus on Windows. All right. The other thing I have to do probably is I have to do path name normalization. Think for a sec. Actually, well, also let me get some mango. All right, where was I in my grand scheme? Physical organization. The one of the basic things I want to do. Okay, let's see. If I do this, that should work as well, right? I should just do a directory listing. Or not. Do you always have to use star? I guess I'll just use read dir then on okay, so I'll just rather than doing the wildcard matching at this level, I'll just I guess I can use find next and just use this. And I need to do proper path manipulation at some point, but for now I'm just going to do the cowardly thing. This is two extra characters. Like I have to prevent double slashes and stuff, but let's do the really. Yeah, I know, you know what? Let's do some path stuff because I think I need to do that eventually anyway. So like path join. Of course, this is just documentation that they're paths. They don't really have to be like that. abstraction here is this be like well, no, so what's the easiest way to do this, maybe? The right logic here. So you have to figure out where to start overwriting. You either start at the zero terminator. So let's say if this is there, or if it's not equal to dust, and let's do it like this. This is cleaner. So then we can just do. Ah, can't decide on the right way to do it. Okay, let's do it this way. So find where to start printing. If the last thing begin or ends in a slash, then we want to overwrite it. If the other thing begins in a slash, then we want to skip it. And then we print our own slash. So let's see. This first try was some stuff with backslashes. Oh.
Idiot.
Normalization should probably also cut off a final slash, right? So, if this is not my normal, doesn't go up. We should also test it about that just to make sure we didn't clobber it. Let's try to do a path join. What's the other cases? Skipping this when we normalize it. About this logic. Total buffer size, and subtract off how far in we are that looks reasonable. The other way of expressing this would be Des plus max path minus putter. Which may be easier to read. All right. So that's it for starters. Now for the listing. By the way, this should be the generic path OS stuff, I think. May want to use it. There. Let's do it like this. If you do Is Reed Deer on Windows? Why am I even doing this? No, I guess there isn't. So maybe this isn't the most reasonable way to do it, but it seems a little bit roundabout. Anyway, let's see what this is. Okay, so that's not. Let's try this with slash. So file spec that. Actually, let me test this one with backslashes just to be really nasty and mix them. First, it's copied. You know what, I think copies should probably normalize it because you always probably want to do something like that, I believe. What happened here? We have to filter out that trash. Just no problem. If let's see, if stir comp is it if hitter valid. Actually, let's just say, call it skip junk. While hitter valid and stir comp. Probably should not be re-entrant in that way. It's like a do while loop. What's the best structure for the skip stuff? So I want to be able to share this code. And let's see what happened here. So it returned true, so it's going to do a skip, do an update, and say, yep, it's still junk. And then it's going to say, no longer junk. All right. Or maybe junk is a little bit wrong word. I mean, if we wanted to have filtering, this is also where you would do filtering in general. So maybe what I really want to say is, it's called matches. So it matches if either not valid. Let's see. It's called shift skip. Junk is good. It's called junk. All right. Just remembered there's some other stuff here that should probably be removed or be moved to a different setup, something more official and API-like. What's the function? The other thing that might be useful is, I'm just realizing this, some of the stuff in, what's called, 32. Might be useful to have a full path as well. Say there's something called the find path, sort of, there's a global constant state. And then when we do this stuff here, the other thing you can do is you can say, which maybe is excessive, but let's just see how that looks. Course, you could compute that yourself. But sort of in the name of convenience, maybe this is nice to have. So you have both the name, and you have not really the absolute path, but the combination of what was passed in, which presumably in the current working directory at the time resolves to something. So even if this is a relative path, this conjunction should be resolvable as long as you haven't changed working directory since then. Which seems reasonable. All right. So let's. So basically, what we want to do is. Guess we have some sort of ion path. Which for now can just be a specific directory, but I want it to be an explicit directory, and so this is the base relative to which package lookups are going to be done, and when you try to resolve something like foo var baz or dot foo, which I guess would be relative to a specific thing. So let's just say foo var baz. It basically, it's the equivalent of doing this. But actually, I don't think we want to specialize to one directory because at the very least, we want to be able to separate the system stuff from the user stuff. So we want to have some sort of list of paths, which are searched in order. Could just be two things, but let's just make it an arbitrary list. And then when you search for a path, it's always going to go through that in order and try to resolve a package spec like this to a directory. That seems reasonable. I need to take a bathroom break, and I'll be right back in a minute or two. back. Let's see if people are saying stuff in chat. Oh, I missed. Alright. Okay, during my short bathroom break, first thing I realized is this should probably be called list, not find, since we're not really doing any filtering. It's incredible. How bad is it? The renamer sometimes a little bit stupid. Okay, let's not rename it if it's going to be stupid like that. And this is a random thing. I just realized during my short bathroom break, this is not something I think I'm going to do, but I realized you can do kind of a spin on my noir design style if you wanted to for this stuff, where you do the following. small design sidetrack, but suppose you do the following. This, I think, maybe a slightly better API. Suppose you have something here called deer, which is the actual. So find path now becomes deer. You have a flag that's init. Then you do the following. That doesn't work. Because valid wouldn't be true initially. I was going to say you could do something like, and then valid, but it wouldn't really work with valid. I guess this wouldn't work. But my idea was that you would somehow do the thing where it starts being null initialized and then it works. Detects the first time through and initializes it, but valid would be false, so that's not going to work very conveniently. Anyway, dumb idea then. Alright, back to the action. So, I think. Oh, not invalid? Yeah, that works. Yeah, I guess not invalid would work, you're right. We're not done. The problem is then you don't have the invariant that if that flag is valid, then you can look at the data, which is not great. I guess that would, yeah. Don't know. Could kind of work, but it would maybe be a little bit potentially confusing. Anyway, let's just stick with this. So, what did I want to do? Packages, packet search. I think, so right now we're hard coding the file to read. Let's make a function to start. Maybe ion is the right place for this. So we need to have some code for listing. We can just start writing it here for now. But like, I don't know, list package. Sorry. So there's an ion path list. Start writing it here and move it somewhere else. So there's so let's see, what are we really trying to do? We're trying to take something like this and resolve it to a specific directory structure. And so on the one hand we have a list of names, and on the other hand we have a list of search directories. This reminds me, we probably need to tag whether something is a directory or not. So if we do something like this, just right through it and see. So, okay, that seems to work. So, what's the basic primitive? I guess one of them would be. Find maybe we call it like a package path or something like that. The other thing I have to consider is that when you see something like A dot B, I think really what you want to do at every step is you start at the root and you try to find you do A B. Try to resolve A to a package, which means each of the routes that you have to search, you see there's something called A. Ugh, my brain is not working today. What is this? Find package, search, path, package spec. It's called a package spec. Actually, let's pass this in separate data structure. Package path. So what do you do? Start here. So you're now finding matches here. And then first have to find, start with the first name. Like this. It's called the current path. We have a current path. We start with the search path, and we keep appending stuff as we expand. And so we start searching in the current path, and we have to match the first name. Wow, this is valid. I'm trying to find a match. While this is valid, you check whether this is equal to this. And if it is, then we found a match. Otherwise, we advance the iterator. Once we've found a match, if we still haven't found a match here, then we didn't find something straight up. At this point, I guess we can say this was not a or if this was a sub not a sub deer. So at this point, we should have something that matches that thing. And so I think what you want to do is you want to, and you could support this directly by having something that can descend into an existing iterator. I think that's actually a good idea. So you want to have a function that's like, when something points to a subdirectory, you want to say, CD. So at this point, basically, you want to create a subdir iterator. You use the path here. And then you copy that over. Free the old one. And you copy over the new one. Why is it complaining about that? Int. Oh. God, I'm really getting tired of using those tablets. What is this? Yeah. I must not have gotten enough sleep. All right. So this keeps descending into subdirectories. And at every step, we actually have to verify that there's ion code, I think. So maybe this is not really the right thing because I think what. No, this is probably okay. You don't have to compile the super packages to use the sub packages. So this matches a name, we try to descend into the subdirectory, and then eventually we're there. And then when we're finally at the end, I think what you do is you let's call it package dir iter. So if I have, if I have something like, packet search header. Base. Search bar. So we start with, for example, let's say bitwise is a root, and then you need. I've noticed that when you're doing compound literals for this stuff, it's convenient to have the first thing first. And so, let's say for now, we first have, we have one component, and it is ion. So we get in this path. We have our own copy that we can. Oh, and I guess now that we have the subdirectory iterator, we actually don't need that current path. So let me kill that. So this seems to be valid. So we get a name. The first one is ion, which is actually the match. And so oh wait, no, that's the thing we're searching for. There's a dot get first. So right, so that doesn't work. Doesn't work either. Okay, and this one does work. Market found, and we break out. And then it should go in here. And it says it is a directory. It is valid. And so now, using this path, it should successfully. Send. Free the old one, we overwrite this. And we are done, we write it out, and everything is peachy keen. Let's try a case where nothing matches. That's false. Let's try a case where we have something like this. So first subdirectory, good. Now we're onto the second component, which is ion. That should also match. So overall, we're good. We now have this kind of subdirectory iterator for that, and then we can do stuff beyond. See. So the next step is to do something that can try multiple in sequence. Search all hitter. Something like that. Then if I do compile package, package path, what kind of stuff needs to go into it? We need to make a list of all the files. For this stuff, we have some global, which is like ion search paths, ion num search paths. So for now, we can just have a static array. Probably. Let's say currently there's two. Let's maybe make some directories here. Just to test. Actually, let's say this is user packages. And there's also built-in packages. System packages. Here there's one called built-in. File
called builtin.ion. Something like that. And so just to get started, let's just hard code this. Let's search here first. So when you compile a package, this stuff should move over somewhere else. Right, so you specify this. You should get back a package. For now, I'm just going to make that some dummy thing. It's going to be a file system path as well. It's going to be a file path. Right, so package path out iter. Now we're here. We want to find all the ion files. And for each of these, you want to basically say, if if this extension, or actually I can do it with the name even. If the name if it's not a subdirectory, and the name ends in .ion, then I will compile it. But right now this thing is not really set up to work quite as nicely as that. Like, I do this compiled built in kind of stuff. So for now, let's just put everything into the global namespace, since we're just working on the physical structure part of packages. So let's do it this way. We want to do this so that we don't accidentally skip that. if it's a directory or there's not an ion extension, then we skip it. Otherwise, we are going to let's first try with just one file with the current physical structure, and then we'll try to split it up into multiple files and make sure it works. So we initialize the stream. This is code. Parse it. Let's not write it out, but we can still run the full pipeline. And step this out. So for now, let's just pass in, let's just treat this as a top level package. So there's one component, and that component, we could say each argument is actually like that. Let's do like that. A little bit funky maybe, but it's just a way to test some stuff without doing package path parser. Actually, for now, let's just return a bool. We can at least do the success failure check out here. Alright, I guess we have to go and change the entry point here again. And then since we're using absolute paths, I think it actually doesn't matter because the search path is absolute. But first, I guess let's just verify that something happens. All right, compilation failed, but why? Right startup project. Guess because we still have the auto build steps, so let's disable those. Temporarily. What now? More. Unloaded stuff. Yeah, so okay, test.ion. So that's not correct. So now, well, we should test that it doesn't actually match anything. Yeah, should return false. So that's correct. Correcto. But we should be able to just say test one. Oh, right. So this is a very good test, actually. Very good test. Because now we can move. What was always my plan, I think, is to move all of this stuff here into the file. What's the multi-cursor stuff in Sublime? I can never remember. Is it Alt? What is it? Control Alt. Anyway, we should now be able to take this and put it in, system packages, built in. And now, rather than doing this sort of stuff, you should be able to do like basically this one is maybe more interesting because if you go in here, the first one should now hit something. Okay, or not. System packages. System packages. Oh, it's just called built in, right? Right, so the first one hits, which normally wouldn't hit. Oh, and you can't. So this, yeah, this is not correct. When you compile a package, you should defer all the finalized stuff for now because don't want to finish. Well, we certainly don't want to do generation. Let me just remind myself, maybe this needs to be refactored. We could do this as a compromise for now. In theory, once the packages are more isolated, we could do this all the way at the end. No, you always want to do this for a single package to finish it off, even if you defer code generation. Then I think you want to do gen all here. Well, gen all doesn't have an error. That will just error out on its own. Okay, that actually worked. C output. this is a package name for now, so it's a single component. Oh, double projects, typo. Okay. Let's reload this project. So that should now be that file. The pound lines are screwed up, so I must not have passed that incorrectly. I think probably, because the path is not permanently allocated, I need to stir dupe it when I pass it in. That's the reason. Like, this stuff is fine, but when I call the compiler with this thing, I need to stir dupe it. We're not going to worry about freeing it for now. So now all of this stuff is correct. And so if I Looks like this is a startup project. And what's the shortcut to start at main? So this is some I rarely use in Visual Studio. Visual Studio debugged. Break at main. I think there's a shortcut for that, even though I never use it. Alright, let's just pull this dude over. So that does get picked up. And if I do the type info test, I should be able to step into the built-ins file as well, which previously wasn't possible because previously the built-ins code came from a string, and so it wasn't actually in a file, which I anticipated being an issue as soon as we did something more fancy than this kind of test crap. Right, so now we actually get into the built-in ion file, which is great. All right. For some reason, I'm really tired and unfocused today, so I may wrap things up at this point, but this is already pretty good. Actually, let me do one more test. Definitely let me do this test first. So if I go to user packages test one, I should be able to put this somewhere else. Like for example, if I make something called foreign.ion, that should just work. So all of that just got, I have to set up my auto build again. And the auto build now is much simpler because it's just test one. Deal with this now because now they're spread over multiple files. Let's just do that. Okay, so this didn't seem to run the compiler. Except because I moved the output file, I mean, I can definitely put it back in. If that makes it happy. Oh, right. Oh, I need to. Okay, so that didn't work. So that was a good test to do. I think what's happening here, this is in the C code, not in the ion code. Whereas I'm sure that if I actually commented this stuff out, I'm pretty sure I would get ion errors, right? Yeah, like it would say there's no un there's no name called printf. But if I move this back, Ion passes its checks, but the C code doesn't get what it needs. So let's look at the C code. So it looks like the foreign pound includes got totally clobbered. Let me put something. Let me put some code here just to make sure that it gets compiled in on the C side. Okay, so I do get stuff from this file. It's just the foreign stuff is not making it through. I see. It's because these things get overwritten. So, what's the best way to deal with that? I think maybe what we want to do for now is we just put everything. Yeah, this is there was this was never clean to begin with. So for now, let's just make we make a function here, and it's just we pass this in. Then it adds to the global decals. How were we using this function before? Yeah, that's just garbage. That should never have existed in that way. So I think what you do instead is you have the same function, but get in a set of declarations. And for now, you add all of them to one big globals list because we don't have namespacing and that stuff. So what you do. Wait, what? I think what you actually do is you make it make it a stretchy buff. Ramp that out. Do all this shit. So these functions need to be renamed badly, but let's just leave it like that for now. Right, this is all mesh. Oh, right, and you want to make this add them. Let's see here. Global decals is a point. Oh no, that's the problem. It should be this. Then all of this stuff should be don't want to make the stretchy buff part of the interface, so I'm going to do something like this. Okay, so it's still not doing the right thing, I guess, but at least I think we're one step closer. Global decals. So let's look at everything on this code path, see if anything blasted out. So when we do this, compile some stuff. Maybe this init compiler thing does some badness. Okay, this is idempotent, so it shouldn't be a big deal. Shouldn't be a big deal either. Should totally be done in here. Add global decals. right? We're still not, or standard IO, so there's still no foreign influence. I think it's because when you do this thing here, this canary did get generated, right? So it looks like this set gets reset. You know, when I do this, so this is foreign. Shouldn't be anything blasting away here. So this was a decal note, and all of that gets added to the set. Oh, I see. This should not be here. It should be there. That was the issue. So these things don't get interned in the symbol table because they're just directives, but they do need to go in the list of declarations so the generator can see them later. I think that was the issue, which makes sense. Yep. So I think that should work now. And I should be able to remove this one, move this into user packages test 2. Well, test 3 is a little bit huge, but I guess we can move that there too. So yeah, I guess let's do the same thing with test 2. Let's make sure we didn't break stuff. And for test 2, we can maybe do something like, again, move this to foreign just to test some of the stuff. Maybe you put this in test.ion or something like that. That should still work. Another change here. No, that should. What about the hello world? That actually generated. Okay, so that's not correct. Oh, I have to run it. Oh, that didn't work. Duplicate definition of global symbol. This is line 4. That's totally busted. I should also have a better error message. Duplicate definition. Maybe I still had the old code there, and that was the problem. Okay, now we're good. We should be able to do foreign include standard.io.h. And actually, now that we have easy ways of adding built-ins, so, I think you can delete this. Then we still need this stuff because it's not included by default. This should not be needed because it's now built-ins. Let's call this main. Let's see. Yeah, I think that worked. If we look at the C file, we should not we have all these things up here now. All right. So that's already like a million times better than what we had before. In the start of the day. I'm going to take a break. I didn't get a proper breakfast, so I'm kind of having a little kind of losing focus a lot. But we did manage to get through the first big chunk of work related to directory search and compiling multiple files into one big blob of things and doing out-of-order stuff between files. We didn't get started on the things that are related to namespacing and specifying imports and stuff like that, and actually separating the namespaces, because right now everything just gets glommed into one big namespace. But this was a prerequisite. This was actually the part I was dreading, because I knew there would be a lot of fiddly OS stuff and whatnot. So I'm actually fairly happy with where we got. I'm probably not going to check this in immediately, because I need to write POSIX versions of my functions. And so it might take a while before I check this in. And this is a bit of an upheaval of all my tests as well, so I don't want those to be failing when I check them in. So this might get checked in later today or tomorrow, once I'm happy with it. But anyway, yeah, not my best stream so far, but managed to get to a good stopping point, I think. So thanks for hanging out, and hope to have this in good state sometime tomorrow. Not just the physical organization parts, but package import directives, namespacing directives, all this stuff, having it all working harmoniously, and also having stuff like command line options properly supported, environment variables where it makes sense. So just kind of making it more well-rounded from a UI perspective. So yeah, that will be done in today and tomorrow. So I'll see everyone next time.